Dear friends, welcome to EPG Pathshala. Myself, Dr. Ashita Ravindran from the National Council of Education, Research and Training, NCERT, shall be interacting with you on the topic Globalization and Education. I'm sure you have heard a lot about globalization, which is the buzzword in today's world. I shall be using this opportunity to share with you the issues, trends, and challenges that globalization have generated in the field of education. At the start, I shall briefly explain globalization and its characteristics. A basic understanding of globalization is a prerequisite for moving ahead in our discussion. Here, the objective is to identify and characterize the key issues that surround the phenomenon known as globalization. Then, we shall move on to deal with the impacts of globalization on education policy and policy formulation. Later, the dilemmas associated with the globalized education system shall be detailed out. This will help in understanding the political, cultural, and economic dilemmas that the globalization brings forth along with its positive impacts. Meanwhile, in this lecture, we shall also explore how globalization of education is changing the fundamental conditions of an education system. As the need of the hour, we need to look into the strategies for globalizing education. Finally, the discussion on the futuristic aims of globalization will help you to develop a rationale for integrating a global perspective in the education system for a sustainable future. Whether you think globalization is a good thing or not, it appears to be an essential element of the economic history of mankind. So, let me initiate my lecture on globalization and education by looking into the phenomenon globalization. What do we understand by globalization? Globalization implies weakening of physical boundaries, wherein there exists free flow of goods, services, capital, people from one country to another without any restrictions. With globalization, we see that the entire world gets transformed into a single global village. The entire world is integrated into one economic space. This happens through increased international trade, internationalization of production and financial markets, and the information revolution. It brings about changes in all walks of life, that is, in social, in economic, in political structure, etc., and education remains to be one among them. The internationalization and excessive competition, along with rapid advances in technology, bring in new demands and pose fresh challenges to the education sector. The shrinking role of the education in the globalized era particularly affects education. Education turns out to be a marketable commodity service. More openness happens, allowing the students to take advantage of educational opportunities available in different parts of the world. When we look into the education sector, we see that there are new demands and fresh challenges. It is all the result of internationalization, excessive competition, and more importantly, rapid advances in technology. The role of the state gets reduced, and now education turns out to be a marketable commodity. As more openness happens with globalization, students are able to take advantage of educational opportunities available in different parts of the world. There are different modes in which globalization of education takes place. For example, there will be namely education institutions that operate on foreign land. Foreign educational institutes open centers in the host countries. Centers, campuses enroll international students. They operate virtual campuses by using satellite, use of cyberspace for marketing education, etc. Let us now look into the characteristics of globalization that most closely affect education. In economic terms, we can see that with globalization, there is a transition in the workplace. There is rise in internationalized advertising, consumption, and investments, and also free flow of goods and workers. The role of the workers, the producers and the consumers changes. This puts in pressure on the education sector. Workers, producers and even consumers are to be trained to meet the demands arising from the globalized world. In political terms, there is a loss of nation-state autonomy and a weakening notion of citizen. The state with its reducing control lose control over their education systems. In terms of culture, also we see that there is great disintegration of the local cultures. Globalization brings forth loss in indigenous culture due to standardization and bring in of cultural homogeneity. Looking in educational terms, even though education is influenced by the state, the educational institutions cannot remain outside the globalization process. Educational institutions, as they enter into the globalized world, turn out to be competitive. This end up in commoditizing and commercialization of education. With its changing role as a marketable commodity, education becomes accessible only to those who can afford. This widening of the education gap will result in rise of income inequalities. We all know that education is capable of raising levels of productivity and mobilizing human capital. It helps in improving the quality of life of people. At every stage of development, there is a need for enhancing the human capabilities. There is a need to formulate policies for education in the pursuit of development, which can reduce the impact of problems associated with globalization. These policies at the same time should be able to capture the opportunities available with the advent of globalization. In the next session, I share the impact of globalization on education, the challenges it poses, and how the education sector needs to mold itself to reap the fruits of globalization. Impact of globalization on the education system. Globalization brings with it opportunities for sharing knowledge, research findings, technology, resources, and social values for which the youth of the world needs to be prepared. There occur fundamental changes in education. The changes are like from national education, it becomes global education. Education considered as a merit good transformed into a market good, which means that from being funded by the state, considering it as a merit good, education now takes form of a market good. From one-time education, it moves towards the lifelong learning. Learning also now becomes learner-centered. We can also see that the state-controlled educational institutes now become market-controlled. Also, the basis of educational institutes and the curriculum as such now will be economic rather than being social. There also arises the concept of education for all. These changes that we see in the field of education due to globalization can bring about both positive and negative impacts. Let us now look into the positive developments that occur along with the global process. First of all, we can see that there is a widening of education access for all, and there is also a shift from one-time learning to the lifelong learning. With globalization, we can also see the creation of networking. There is an increased demand for skill enhancement for meeting up with the job roles that are changing as well as challenging. We also find that the advent of internationalization and competition, there is a need for development of global research institutes. Overall, the globalization results in shift from national to global education. Scope for online education increases, and thereby there is a cultural integration. We also see that there is an uprise in the opportunities for sharing knowledge, skills, technology, resources and social values. If we look at the negative side of globalization, we find that there is a loss of cultural identity, and it can lead to dominance of culture and values of advanced countries. on the positive side, we have seen that there is a chance of cultural integration forced in by the global process. This means that along with the cultural integration, there is also loss of cultural identity happening. See, this is because most of the time when the cultural integration happens, the dominance of culture and values of the advanced countries is prevalent, and here the cultural identity of many countries fade off. The technological gaps that exist can hinder the equal opportunities for fair global sharing and thereby increase the inequalities. This increase in inequalities can lead to conflicts between areas and cultures. Money or the capital taking out the leading role, there can be an erosion of social and cultural values. This is something which we are witnessing around us. Left to the world of competition, there is an exploitation of the less developed countries and exclusion of the disadvantaged. On the negative side, we can also see that being global, there is a neglect of local needs as well as the local problems. That becomes nobody's concern. Also, globalization encourages brain drain. With the free movement in place, there will be more and more educated and skilled going out to the advanced countries. This movement in search of better avenues can bring about brain drain within the country. So, we have till now dealt with the positive as well as the negative effects that globalization can bring in. We have seen that education, when it is geared into the demands of the corporate world, it not only results in economic development, but also in inequality owing to the lack of accessibility to education skills, market, technology and resources. Let us now look at these effects in detail. We shall classify them under commodification, internationalization, nationality and openness of knowledge. First, we shall deal with commodification of education. Friends, let us look at what happens with the advent of globalization. Here, with globalization setting in, the use values are replaced by exchange value. Everything, including education, is looked upon as a commodity. These commodities are produced and delivered in line with the market forces. It follows the principles of supply and demand. One by one, water, electricity, postal services, health, and now education have been turned into a commodity driven by market forces. Education acquires the character of commodity, which is marketable for profit making. Then what happens when education becomes a commodity? The commodification of education will bring in competition. The institutions are pressurized to put in efforts to strive for their existence. Students also enter into the competitive world. Subsidized education moves off. Market decides the cost of education. This increases the cost of education. As we all know, the increase in the cost of education can make it inaccessible to many. So, we can see that the commodification of education will be leading to inequality in the access of quality education. This commodification of education can increase its cost, making it unaffordable to marginalized. They remain excluded, thereby making the poor sections of the society remain deprived of the growing opportunities also. Now, let us look at the commodification of education in a positive way. As a positive impact of commodification, we can see that there is an increase in the private institutions within the country, and also students get opportunity to study at any institutions outside the country. There is an increase in access due to the crossing of borders. But at the same time, we can see that education programs in the developed countries attain more dominance in the market, of course, due to their reach in advanced knowledge and technology. Also, with the mushrooming of number of institutions bringing in uniform quality control may now turn to be difficult. Internationalization of education. Now, coming to the next impact, internationalization of education. With the advent of globalization, the curriculum and the course acquire international orientation along with the composition of international faculty and students. The acceptance of various cultures and its integration in teaching learning process enhances the quality of education. The learners get acquainted with a diverse source of knowledge about the world. They understand the cultural difference and similarities that exist. With globalization, there is more collaboration of educational institutions and it also attracts foreign investments. This internationalization will help in improving the courses. It will also help in technology transfer, exchange of faculty and students. It can also lead to the conduct of research on international aspects, conduct of joint research studies, etc. These are the positive sides of internationalization. Now, coming to the negative side, internationalization of education has a disadvantage of not addressing the local needs and local problems. The curriculum, standards, learning outcomes, etc. are often determined by the sponsoring institutions. This will not help in fostering national development of the recipient country. Also, due to the unfavorable currency exchange rate, the students of developing countries find it difficult to go for studies in developed nations under the exchange programs. Now, coming to the next factor, that is the nationality. Another factor that gets greatly affected with the advent of globalization is the nationality. With globalization, the sovereignty gets reduced. The nationality becomes more open. The increasingly international environment leads to reducing importance of the national regulatory and policy frameworks. Institutions faced by global competition and cooperation enter into partnerships and networks in order to strengthen their position. Now, the next point, that is the openness or the accessibility of knowledge. When we look at the accessibility of knowledge, with the advent of globalization, there is a wide range of knowledge available to the learners. The new communication technologies that builds in between the teachers and learners across the world help in better comprehension of concepts, ideas, etc. This also creates a global view of education. Online and distance learning enables people to enter into the world of lifelong learning. They gain access to different courses offered by various institutions across the world. Like you, there are a number of learners resorting to the online courses available on their own desktops or laptops and learning at their own pace and time. Now, to get a degree from Oxford or Harvard or Cambridge, you need not go there and study. Some of these are available at your doorsteps. More are set to come in future. Even though it has the disadvantage of loss of the human touch by way of oral interaction with the peers and teachers, this virtual classroom brings in the educational integration. So, we have seen how globalization brings in commodification of education, internationalization of education, openness of knowledge, and how it reduces the nationality. All these impacts of globalization drive us towards certain dilemmas associated with globalized education system. They can be classified into economic, political, and cultural problems. Let us now look at it in detail. It is the dilemmas of a globalized education system. First of all, let us deal with the economic dilemma. On the economic front, we can see that education being guided by the demand base. With globalization, we have a world without borders. It demands people to be competitive enough to fulfill the demand in the job market by acquiring the requisite skills and knowledge. The learners need to be equipped with new skills and competencies. They need to be flexible to adapt the changes in the job market. This necessitates the development of curriculum and syllabi that can ensure to fulfill manpower needs. Another problem from the economic point of view is degrees of spending on education by the government. With globalization, we know that there is increase in the mobility of firms and individuals. The government needs to create a tax-friendly environment so as to ensure individuals and companies stay in the country. Creating tax-friendly environment means decrease in tax revenue for the government. This forces government to reduce its expenditure, thereby leading to the reduced spending on education sector. This is a withdrawal of the state from education. This promotes market approach in education and deregulation in the sector. The educational institutions aim at being self-reliant. This can be possible only by being competitive, and therefore these institutions practice the principle of full cost pricing. Now coming to the political dilemma. Let us now look into the political dilemma. We have already seen that the economic change that happens with globalization also leads to a loss of power by national authorities. The global networks become more powerful and influential than the policies of the national governments. The national state policies remain to be inadequate. They are not capable of addressing the rising internationalization of global divergences and environmental concerns. There is a need for fostering education towards global citizenship from national citizenship. On the cultural side, it is a cultural dilemma. We can see that educational policy, practices and society are deeply affected by the global changes. The interaction with people of diverse cultures can promote better understanding, but it may also result in copying of lifestyles and culture. Creation of money becomes the central point of education. The cultural identity tends to be ignored. We can see that the local cultural aspect of the community disappears. This is replaced with a global culture. Now, next we will deal with the strategies for globalizing education. We have already seen how globalization has brought in transition in the consumption and investment processes across borders and within the nation states. There is an exchange of commodities, views, thoughts and other aspects of traditions happening. This paves way for the international integration. Now let us look at what are the strategies for globalizing education. The multidimensional impacts of globalization on education underlines the need for systemic reforms in education with emphasis on research and development activities. We have seen that education without borders, a result of globalization, is in prospect. This results in pooling up of the best intellectual resources, support and initiatives from different parts of the world for learning, teaching and research. Educational institutions initiate international exchange programs, international visits or engagement programs, interactions, sharing of information and knowledge through web-based learning, video conferencing, use of internet across the countries. We know that globalization with its benefits and potential dangers is here to stay. The need of the hour is to evolve an appropriate framework so as to derive its maximum benefits, nullifying the negative impacts. As we have discussed earlier, there are many positive effects that globalization can bring forth. But for all these positive changes to happen, there needs to be a change in the existing structure, policies and mode of delivery of education. We need to rethink and restructure education in order to make our children capable of meeting the challenges. The major concern here is to find out ways to maximize the positive effects of globalization while also putting efforts to minimize the negative effects. We have seen that with the extending and passing on of the information and knowledge across the borders, the level of eminence of students has increased. This academic benefit due to the globalization will certainly help in meeting the huge demand for quality workers that are in existence. There is also the social benefit of preparing the younger generation with attitudes and capabilities. This can lead to lifelong learning, better social ethical understanding and enthusiasm. We can see that there exists a two-way relationship between globalization and education. Globalization widens the education opportunities. In turn, the advancement in education paves way for globalization. How do we capture the benefits of globalization? We need to have job-oriented courses as per the market needs. Our strategy for capturing the benefits of globalization needs to focus on generating job-oriented courses as per the market needs. We need to create human capital that can be used in the global job market. There is also a need to create job opportunities in tune with the advanced skill process by the citizens. The lack of job opportunities in the less developed nations may lead to brain drain, wherein the human capital moves out seeking the better avenues. Creation of job opportunities in tune with the advanced skill process can hold the trained human power from moving out of the country. We need an updated curriculum and syllabi. Also, we need to have an updated curriculum and syllabi. Visionary changes in educational institutions are expected to be made by replacing reproductive education with the problem-solving proposition. The curriculum needs to be reorganized. It has to enable the learner acquire the skills of critical thinking, problem solving, communication skills, ability to approach the problem systematically and also collaborate cross-culturally along with the use of latest technology. Educational institutions need to develop a sense of competitiveness amongst them. They should be enabled to design new courses, curricula, gearing it towards the realizing job opportunities. While developing the curricula and the course design, educational institutions need to keep in mind the demands of the corporate sector. Use of ICT. Another strategy could be the effective use of information and communication technology. This can help in reaping the benefits of global education. There is also a dire need for collaboration, partnership and networking that is to be established. To be part of internationalization, the education institutions can start offering cross-border courses in areas where they have comparative advantage. Pooling in the best intellectual resources from different parts of the world for learning, teaching and research, and along with the use of international standards and benchmarks, these all will bring in the positive impact. Community level participation to support the micro planning in education can bring in the linkage and interaction between educational institutions and communities, which will lead to effective and qualitative education. Even while we orient our education more towards meeting the demands of the job sector, education also should impart human values. Furthermore, the technological advancement and international exposure should not be endangering our social cultural heritage. Rather, it needs to inculcate positive attitudes towards one's own culture and philosophy. We can also think of having a mechanism for evaluating and grading the educational institutions. It will help in enhancing quality, standards, and diversity. Opportunities are to be provided to all to obtain quality education, and special emphasis is to be laid in development of the disadvantaged groups, thereby promoting social inclusion. All these strategies can help us in ensuring a better globalized world. Now, let us summarize what we have learned so far. Till now, we have outlined the process of globalization and its characteristics that affect education. We have explored the interconnectedness between globalization and education and its impact by way of commercialization, internationalization, nationality, and openness of knowledge. The economic, political, and cultural dilemmas associated with globalization and the measure to be taken for globalizing education have been discussed. All these discussions have helped us in deriving how the education needs to be reshaped to build more space for the pursuit of national development. We have seen that the issues that globalization brings forth are the rising inequities, changing role of nation state, and commodification of education. To conclude our discussion, we have seen that to benefit all participants of globalization, education needs to be responsive to the trends and challenges of globalization. With globalization, there emerges a trend for lifelong learning, need for accelerating changes in the mode of delivery, and also multilingual education. Countries need to adopt policies and strategies to make it more equitable in the highly interdependent world. There is a need to bring about changes in the vision, content, and curricula. We also need to address the issues of technological gaps and digital divides. The orientation of education needs to be towards innovation, with the curricula aiming at developing creative and critical thinkers with collaborative skills. They need to have capacity to think in abstractions and approach the problems systematically. Our students need to be capable of communicating cross-culturally. They also should be able to make use of modern technology. This education can prepare us for our economic role and also help us to become fully human. We have seen the need for integrating global perspective in the education system for the sustainable future. Before I conclude, I would like to put forth that instead of allowing the markets and globalization to change education, we need to put in efforts for globalizing education. This can be by way of taking steps for minimizing the dangers and at the same time capturing the opportunities that are created by markets and globalization. Thank you.